ghost ships flying through the air. The cable cars that fly above Sugarloaf Mountain in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Visitor who is privileged to contemplate this remarkable city from a vantage point on the surrounding hills cannot fail to be seduced. There, stretching into the distance, are the famous landmarks that extend gradually into the sea. Cruising high above the beautiful landscapes in a cable car, the visitor sometimes gets the impression of actually flying through the skies. Obviously, some find it more satisfactory to do their own flying in helicopters. Unfortunately, at some point in time, the high-flying visitor has to come back to Earth. However, even when one is no longer flying high above the earth, the landscapes of Rio de Janeiro remain etched in the mind. I was delighted to be taking so many beautiful memories away with me.
This is Ola Balogun reporting for NTA 2, Channel 5, overlooking Rio de Janeiro in Brazil.
No visit to Rio de Janeiro would be complete without an encounter with the gigantic statue of Christ at Corcovado. I was happy to sacrifice to the ritual.
This is Ola Balogun for NTA 2, Channel 5, from Corcovado, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Toda encharcada nas águas de março, Lígia procura o abrigo de abraço. Que o poeta das estrelas escreveu pra ela.
Rio de Janeiro is not all landscapes, however. One bright sunny day, I found myself speeding through the streets to a very special appointment. Someone had kindly agreed to tell me all about capoeira, a unique form of martial arts created by the Afro-Brazilian population. Interestingly enough, capoeira is inconceivable without its musical accompaniment. And not just any kind of music. The practice of capoeira is based on music supplied by the berimbau, a musical instrument that is believed to have originated in Angola. My newfound friends, the martial arts instructor and his pupils, first undertook to familiarize me with the peculiar sonorities of the berimbau.
Aos tempos, o negro trazido da África como escravo, muito massacrado, tratado como coisa.
It is in the midst of untold hardship and suffering that capoeira evolved as a means of defense and self-protection among the slave population. Capoeira was originally a form of combat, and even the berimbau itself could be used as a weapon.
Desse negro africano chegado como escravo, surge aqui no Brasil a capoeira. A capoeira surge como uma luta de liberdade. A capoeira surge como um grito no meio de um povo massacrado, que é o nosso povo, nossos ancestrais negros.
Berimbau are made with different sizes of calabash resonators. Obviously, each size has its own distinct range of sounds, which are created by plucking and striking a string that is attached to the two ends of the berimbau.
É o maior que tem. Nós chamamos de berimbau de barriga. É o nome dele. Berimbau de barriga, berra boi. O nome dele é berra boi, porque a cabaça é grande. Berra igual boi.
Praticamente esse berimbau, a gente pega ele na mata. Pega, corta ele. Esse arame é de pneu de carro. Corta o arame, aí faz isso. E a cabaça também é da natureza.
Perceba esse som, que você vai ver que esse som já é diferente do outro. Ó. Som mais agudo. Vamos lá. Ó.
Most of the songs that accompany capoeira performances have been handed down from generation to generation.
Negro é aquela raça que lutou pra se.
But some new songs are also constantly being composed.
This one tells of the suffering of the Africans who were brought to Brazil as slaves.
These days, capoeira is mostly practiced as a form of stylized dance consisting of fluid movements performed in rhythm to the music of the berimbau.
Beleza?
Axé.
Axé.
Muito axé. Aquela galera lá se amarra. Muita força.
A gente é da Nigéria. Você disse alguma coisa.
Beleza? Grande povo maravilhoso. Coração do mestre Arerê. Beijo grande pra vocês.
Obrigado.
Isso.
In preparation for Carnival, a large crowd gathers every weekend at Ilhéu, the foremost black cultural center in Salvador, capital of Bahia province, to practice drumming and dancing. From the berimbau music that accompanies capoeira, it is only a short step to other forms of African-derived music that permeate cultural life in Brazil. I found that the young black population is keen to preserve their cultural heritage through music. Listening to the enthusiastic drummers at Ilhéu, it is easy to perceive that the roots of the popular Brazilian contemporary music known as samba lie mostly in Africa. Today, samba is a heritage that belongs to the entire Brazilian population. Old and young, they love samba. The crowd that showed up for a giant open-air concert at Pelourinho Square in Salvador were of all generations and color, united by a shared passion for samba music. A fascinating song that resonated deeply with the audience paid homage to Oshun, a Yoruba river goddess. Anything that prospers in streams and rivers belongs to Oshun, the song says. The blessing of water is from Oshun. Na água doce, na cidade brilha. Na água doce. Later the same night, I encountered Martin da Vila, a wonderful musician who charmed the audience into singing the words of one of his most popular songs along with him. Life will get better by and by. A vida vai melhorar. Life is surely going to get better. No wonder everyone is happy to sing along with Martin da Vila. Indeed, life is bound to be better someday.
Valeu, obrigado, gente. Foi.
Nigéria. Viva África.